when we speak of foundations of democracy, of course, we may speak of foundations in terms of principles, in terms of basic agreements, in terms of institutions, institutional foundations of democracy. We may even speak of economic foundations of democracy. I remember within the political science literature, some authors argue that without a minimum degree of per capita income, you cannot have democracy. Although India, for long, falsified them. Anyway, I didn't have a PowerPoint presentation, and in my opening speech, I would like to talk about two foundations, what I consider two foundations of democracy in terms of principles. I think that these two foundations are essential, and they constitute the basis for other foundations. One of the basic foundations of democracy, I think, is moral equality. We've been talking about the concept of equality since the beginning of our session. But we need to clarify equality, and I think what is essential for democracy is moral equality. And the second foundation, I think it is related to the first one as well, plurality, pluralism. The existence or maintenance of pluralism within society. What do I mean by this? Allow me to briefly explicate them, then I shall give the floor to my partner. My starting point is the great Greek philosopher Aristotle. All of you remember Aristotle's tripartite analysis. Rule by one, rule by a few, rule by many, or rule by all. And Aristotle argued that, as you know, democracy is the rule of all, what we now call the rule of people. When we speak of rule of all, it means that every member of all, whatever that all is, whether it is a nation or a city of Athens or Republic of Turkey, every member of the all has the same right, same chance to rule. So it means that every member of the all is equal. But this is not a physical equality. This is something moral equality. So by moral equality, what I mean is then every member of the society, every member of the polity, morally equal in the sense that each of them has a valuable opinion, a valuable say, as valuable as each other. This is in modern society now, we articulate this as, or in the principle, one man, one vote principle, for example. Whether you are a professor, whether you are a carpenter, whether you are rich or poor, you have just one vote, because you are equal, morally equal. And moral equality, I think, goes for, not only for the voting, but for the ideas, opinions. My idea, as valuable as yours. No more, no less. This is what I mean, moral equality. So, in my mind then, democracy, in democracies you have no universal truth. no such thing as truth. There are many truths, no universal truth and no hierarchy among those opinions. Everybody is capable of and morally valuable to take part in ruling. I think this is the indispensable foundation. If democracy is the rule of all, it means that all have their views, their opinions, but we cannot expect all members having the same view, having the same beliefs. Even if they have same views, we cannot expect them to maintain this. So in the future, in practice, they may have different opinions, different views. So this brings us to diversity or pluralism. I mean, if everybody has the same view, then what is the point of making a discussion? So democracy then involves pluralism. Every idea, in the morning, a friend of us argued in the United States, you may not argue in defense of, for example, ideas in some positions. So this shows the lack of pluralism. It does not show it does not show the absence, but it shows the degree of pluralism. But every idea or opinion, every ideology, whatever you say, every thought, because they are morally good, they must be maintained in a sense. So this is pluralism. Of course, there is one condition for these two foundations, I think, unless they resort to violence. Because when there is violence, we cannot speak of society. This is a lengthy argument in the literature, starting from the law onwards. So, without resorting to violence, everybody is more equal and every opinion counts. I think this is the basis of democracy and very foundations of democracy and all other foundations, like the existence of rule of law, multi-party systems, all other institutions, they follow these basic agreements in my mind. Having said this then, I have questions for the floor. One is, how to assure pluralism within society? I mean, we have pluralism, but in practice, in some segments, some sections of the society, they may become hegemonial. They may hegemonize public space, and then monopolize it. So, how to assure pluralism in public space so that it does not get monopolized by one party? And this is the basic issue. In terms of moral equality, my question is, although since we are all living in a, I use in quotation, civilized society and we are civilized people, it's not difficult for us to accept this moral equality. But in practice, we do not see this very often. For example, all of you remember that when Trump emerged as a candidate for United States presidency, many people in the world, in the United States, including myself, we considered it as a joke. We treated it as a joke. Why? Because behind us, behind our minds, unconsciously, we think that Trump is not morally equal. He does not have the right to govern a big state. So it is not easy to come to terms with moral equality. I mean, Trump is not my cup of tea, but it shows that moral equality is not something as simple as it is said. So how to accept moral equality? And in this, my question is, does education has something to do with it? When people get educated, do they accept moral equality more, or they deny it? They may think that, like Plato, for example, they may think that we must be governed by wise men. So, having said this, I think I should stop here and